I'm Chris.
I'm Mark.
And this is Sportsnet at the Movies. And in this episode, we are going to be talking about the basketball scene.
That's Catwoman!
We appreciate your choosing our theater. Enjoy the movie. Thank you.
Let's talk about Catwoman.
Everyone's favorite Batman-related movie. 100%. 100%.
This one?
2004's Catwoman, starring Halle Berry and Benjamin Bratt. It's cool.
Let's go shoot some hoop.
All right, who are the athletes in this scene?
Okay, so in this scene, the people playing basketball, if you can call it that, are Benjamin Bratt, who plays Tom Lone.
Tom Lone.
Officer Tom Lone.
Tom.
Yeah, he takes his job very seriously, yeah, too. That's what I've heard.
Real seriously.
He goes, that's why it never works out with me and partners. They say I take my job too seriously. I'm playing basketball on the job.
And then we've got Patience Phillips, who is Halle Berry.
AKA Catwoman.
At one point, the sexiest woman alive, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, she was. So.
I think, like, at the time, that was really close to her reign. You know, you're on top of the world. You win an Oscar. You're sexiest woman alive. You are Catwoman. Wow. And I'm going to be in Catwoman, directed by Pitoff. And Pitoff.
Oh, yeah. Pitoff. Oh, that Pitoff. Mark?
Yes.
Why are they playing basketball in Catwoman?
I'll tell you exactly why. She meets Tom Lone. Patience meets Tom Lone.
And feels bad that she stands him up. Some of her friends are that he's like doing a talk at the motivational talk at school, or like he coaches basketball.
And this kid's like, hey, you guys, one-on-one?
One-on-one?
And she's like, who, me? And he's like, who, me? And they're like, they're like, the kids are all cheering them on for some reason. They don't want to play themselves.
Round one. Fight!
I feel like the beginning of this, though,
it's like they're stuck in a glitch, looking at each other, bouncing the ball, and then stealing the ball, and then being like, okay, now I got it, right? And then they're like, okay, cool, now I got it.
Yeah.
It's like, no, I got it, I can do it now. And it's like, okay, guys, shoot the ball.
Somebody drive wide, you know, go to the paint, go hard to the paint, do
anything,
something.
Right?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
God.
Is like when you're trying to figure out a video game for the first time, and you're just button mashing and pressing and wiggling the joystick.
But you're like, how do I shoot? How do I shoot? Yeah. I just want to shoot. And she's still like, ha ha ha, doing like this
shoot
stuff.
The ball, yeah. And he's going like, oh, I kind of like this.
yeah. Oh, geez, I hurt my back.
Are you okay?
Ice.
We need some ice.
I'm not kidding.
Some ice.
For real. Power rankings for this one are pretty simple.
Yeah.
We have two people. I think it's pretty obvious. One person won, one person lost the game.
Fatality.
Let's power rank all the Catwomen of the past. The on-screen Catwomen.
Beautiful. Love it.
No, I haven't even said who they are yet, but you know.
Well, I know who they are.
Okay, well, name them then. Go on.
Okay, Michelle Pfeiffer was Catwoman in Batman Returns.
Of course.
And
With her whip.
With her whip, yes.
All right.
And then we've got Anne Hathaway, who was in The Dark Knight Rises. Yeah.
Halle Berry, obviously, was Catwoman.
Yeah. And then there's the untouchable in the Hall of Fame of Catwomen.
Truly, the OG.
OG Julie Newmar.
Okay, so let's do the rankings from the bottom up.
We're going to go franchise.
Franchise.
Trade.
Trade.
And then release.
Release.
Okay.
But there's four. What's the fourth option?
Well, Julie Newmar is Hall of Fame. She's untouchable.
Untouchable.
She's untouchable.
Already
she's
in
Hall
of fame.
Yeah. She's the owner. She's the coach. She's the general manager.
Right.
She's the whole.
She's everything.
She is everything. I am going to franchise Michelle Pfeiffer.
You got it.
I would trade Anne Hathaway.
For what?
A bag of catnip.
Yep. Thank you. I was going to say a bag of catnip.
And then I'm going to have to release straight up.
You're going to release? Patience Phillips?
Halle Berry is getting released and her contract is completely dead. That's it.
Wow. I would love to disagree with you, but I honestly rank it all the exact same.
Yeah.
Julie Newmar, I'm naming an arena after her.
Yeah, Julie Newmar Arena.
Wow. Yeah. So good, too.
Catwomen are not contained by the rules of society.
All right, it's things we learned. So, James, what do you have for us?
The director, Pitoff, has gone on record saying he's never seen a basketball game.
It shows. Could he not have, there's college basketball, professional basketball, there's high school basketball. Like, none of these kids, when they got on that set, you're trying to tell me none of those kids took that ball and took a shot?
Can we have our ball back?
Not on camera, at least.
Follow-up fact.
Yes.
That wasn't true, but 100% you guys believed it,
wow,
didn't you?
Wow, we just went for, 8 minutes about this. Knew this guy was lying with some of his facts. Now the viewers can't even trust you.
What sport should Catwoman play? Can she play another sport? Is parkour a sport?
Yeah, that's a sport. That's a sport.
Okay, I think she'd be good at parkour.
I think so too. I mean, she beats up Sharon Stone, right?
Yeah, right, some UFC, get her in the octagon.
Oh my God, okay, wait. Right? Get her in the octagon, that's it.
Yeah. Well, that's a wrap on this episode of Sportsnet at the Movies. Tell us what you think. Leave a comment in the section below.
Ring the bell like you're trying to get your cat's attention for dinner, you know?
Like there's some whiskers in the coming out of the oven there.
There's a new can of tuna, and it's a video from the Sportsnet at the Movies guys.
I'm hungry.
I'm hungry. You ever eat dog food or cat food?
Never.
This is a new big question I'm throwing in late. Okay. Late to the game, but you ever eat pet food?
No, have you?
No.
Okay.
Anyway, ring the bell, subscribe if you want to get more videos from us, and you got anything else to say?
I'm hungry, so I'm going to go have some cat chow.